Dear Bhagwan, why are there so many people in the West that live alone and not in a relationship or partnership? Thank you, Bhagwan.
The accelerated change that is taking place all over the world is breaking up the system which we call society. As the system is breaking apart, the subsystem, which is the family, is also breaking. That is why these things are happening. So, what is responsible for this is the accelerated change that we are witnessing all over the world. And the old is dying and the new is taking birth, and we do not know what is the new. As the old breaks, the families also break up. That's what we are witnessing right now.
Dear Bhagwan, how can the individual help the Switzerland to express the divine idea? Thank you, Bhagwan.
If individuals transform, then the country changes, because you are the country. So if more and more individuals transform themselves, your society, your country is going to change. The subsystem, if something happens there, the system would naturally change. When the system changes, it affects the subsystem. Similarly, when the subsystem changes, it affects the system. So we are working on not transforming society, we are working on transforming the individual. As individuals change, society changes.
Dear Bhagwan, the outer life is getting more and more difficult. The difficulties seem to accelerate. What does help us? What do we need? Where, when there is so much of doubts and disbelief?
Outer life is going to become more and more difficult, as also inner life. The easiest way out is to have the divine in your life. If the divine becomes your friend, you'll be able to face the crisis very, very easily. What is now most important is to get the divine into your life.
Dear Bhagwan, what is the biggest consolation? What can you tell me to comfort me when I feel so bad and hopeless that I do not forget about the source, the divine, and I do not lose touch with the divine? Thank you, Bhagwan.
Once you get the divine physically into your life, this question does not arise at all.
Dear Bhagwan, can you please tell us more about the dark night of the soul? So many people seem to get in touch with the dark night of the soul after awakening. Thank you, Bhagwan.
The dark night of the soul throughout the centuries has been a clear indication that you are rapidly growing on the spiritual path. So you should be very happy it is happening to you, and you do not have to worry, it'll go on and on. It lasts for a few months and then it stops.
Dear Bhagwan, in one of the darshans you mentioned that we all exist in several bodies at the same time on this planet. My question is, Bhagwan, what happens if we meet one of the other bodies that are us? Thank you, Bhagwan. All my gratitude and love.
When you meet one of the other bodies, you feel completely one with it. You see no difference at all. It's a very, very strange experience.
Beloved Bhagwan, why is it so important that the physical heart gets transformed, since all spiritual masters stress on the spiritual heart? Thank you, Bhagwan.
Only when the physical heart is transformed, does the spiritual heart flower. Without the physical heart undergoing those changes, you would not develop a spiritual heart. And only when the heart physically flowers, you get the feeling of connection with others, you discover unconditional love, you feel very responsible, you feel very concerned, and you care for all that is. So this is not something conceptual, it's a living experience for which the physical heart has got to change. That happens after the brain has changed. First, the brain has got to change, and then the physical heart begins to change.
Dearest Bhagwan, when my personal divine manifest eats and lives with me, what does my friend and my spouse see? What should I tell them? Do I have to have a separate bed for my personal divine? Do I have to cook for my divine? Do I have to provide clothes for my divine? Thank you, Bhagavan.
It all depends on you. What kind of relationship you have with your divine? It is not that only you must cook always. The divine too could cook for you. So what the divine demands depends on your relationship with the divine. Of course, when your friends come home and they also see the divine, what you tell them depends on you. You could tell them, my friend is here. Suppose you tell them the divine is here, they might not believe you. So it depends upon you, your friends. Ultimately, the decision is yours. You should not always think that the divine would be very, very demanding. Not at all. The divine also would help you in keeping your house clean, in cooking, all that the divine could do. It depends upon what kind of relationship you're going to have. That's why we tell you, create your own God. God cannot be created, but then the kind of relationship you have with God depends on you. On that, the whole phenomenon would happen.
Thank you. Dearest Bhagwan, how many people need to have a strong wish for a miracle so that it can actually happen? Is it enough when a single person has a strong wish for a miracle to make it happen? Thank you, Bhagwan.
It is good to have more people pray for a miracle. However, even if there's a single individual who could pray strongly, that is enough.
Dearest Bhagwan, does in the golden age the existing society gets transformed, or must the old first disappear in order to make space for the new one? Thank you, Bhagwan.
The old disappears. As the old begins to disappear, the new one takes birth.
Beloved Bhagwan, in Golden City, we were told that there is the ancient mind. Does also a new mind exist, or will it come into existence? Thank you, Bhagwan.
Right now, we are not talking of a new mind. We are talking about being free of the mind.
Dearest Bhagwan, when awakened, we have more and more a deep connection with being in oneness. Why is it still so important to be in communion with others and to live in community? Thank you, Bhagwan.
If you live in a community, you would grow very, very fast. It would be amazingly quick.
Beloved Sri Bhagwan, what is the better thing to do? To focus on enlightenment or to focus on God realization? Thank you, Bhagwan.
It is better to focus on enlightenment first. Seeing your divine physically and talking to your divine physically is not God realization. There is much more to God realization than physically seeing and talking to your divine. God realization is possible only if you are enlightened. Therefore, you have to first focus on your enlightenment. If you do it on your own, it's a long process. If the divine comes physically into your life, it happens very, very fast. Get the divine first into your life and become enlightened. Then go for God realization.
This is the last question, Bhagwan. Dear Bhagwan, what is necessary to lift the consciousness in Switzerland? Is it the level of awakening of the awakened ones, or is the number of awakened ones that is important? Thank you, Bhagwan.
Both are important. The number of people who are awakened and their levels of awakening. All this would be speeded up very, very fast once you start getting the divine physically into your lives.